And in business, Zainab Ahmed, the Minister of Finance, Budget and National Planning, says implementation of a value-added tax increase from 5% to 7.5% will take effect from February 1st. Ahmed said this during the inauguration of the chairman and board members of the Federal Inland Revenue Service in Abuja on Thursday. We plan that going forward, the annual budget will always be accompanied by finance bills to ensure to enable the realization of revenue projections. The Finance Act has also taken care of essential palliatives to support micro, small and medium enterprises and mitigate the impact of VAT rate increase on the most valuable businesses, commodities and citizens in the economy. Here with me in the studio is Gospel Obele. He is an economist. Thank you so much for joining me in the studio.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, regarding the VAT increase from 5% to 7.5%, what's your take on it?
Well, I think it's basically the Finance Act is a good bill, it's a good one, in terms of if you look at it from ease of doing business and all that. But for that increase in taxes, in the tax rate, in the VAT rate, I just think it's a rise in that cost implications for businesses. And I don't think it's moving in the right direction. I would have thought that we would have encouraged, in terms of tax compliance, expanding the tax net rather than the rate. So there are more things to do or that can be done in encouraging that tax compliance. Even at 5%, there are more persons who are evading taxes. There has to be incentive to get them on board. There are social capital issues around trust and accountability that needs to be dealt with from the fiscal end. So it seems more like to me we are trying to enforce a policy, you know, to cover that fiscal indiscipline that currently happens. You know, when you look at the revenue side of the budget, it's more of a fiscal indiscipline question on why we have a revenue crisis than a tax issue per se. So we need to, you know, fix the social capital and create incentives to bring more on board, more people into the tax net than increasing the rate. What the rate will only do for those, in quote, seemingly thriving businesses above 25 million would be to increase the cost of doing business for them, which also counter negates the ease of doing business agenda by the government. So yes, ease of doing business works for SMEs, you know, but you know, SMEs need to get to a point where they can thrive and create jobs, you know, to take out that,
exactly,
you know, take out the critical mass from the unemployment space and all that. And for businesses that are seemingly thriving, they are the ones that are caught up in the new tax regime and all that. So I don't think it makes a lot of sense. I think it's a policy used, like many other policies by the federal government, it's patchy. It doesn't deal with the core issues around social accountability, social capital, and encouraging more people into
tax. Do you see this particular policy now? Do you see this particular move actualizing the purpose for which it has been created?
Well, I think it's a reactive move than a proactive move. So, yes, it may be, the purpose may be actualized in the sense that it would increase revenue because organizations may not necessarily have so much option than to abide. And there's a lot of reforms internally in the FIRS to encourage that. What would happen is that organizations will end up splitting that cost. You know, either they will put the cost on the employees or on the final consumer. That's what will happen. On the other end of things, you find out that we'll have to wait to, you know, get the revenues from this increase in VAT before can channel them into health infrastructure and all that.
But if you take a look, finally, because of time now, okay, yeah. Do you think Nigerians are ready for this particular move? In terms of, I mean, not everybody's income would be increased, right?
Nigerians are basically not ready because it's a strong survivor-driven environment. So people are still trying to get their heads above the waters, and then you impose this. So I don't think it's a good move in the right direction. I think a lot more needs to be done around social accountability and encouraging people into the tax net. And you know, a whole lot more honesty has to be done around the budget financing process, the revenue, the debt servicing, and all the likes. If you look at the 2019 implementation report, you find that as at second quarter, 58% of the 2019 budget has been implemented, but was on the revenue side. So was on the expenditure side, you had so much on recurrent expenditure, and as at the second quarter, capital expenditure had not hit 1 trillion yet. Mm. So even if yes, we increase revenue from this new initiative, you will find out that even the recurrent expenditure side of the budget would, you know, amount for so much of that revenue expenditure than what the capital, what should be happening in terms of the real investments, infrastructure, and like. So I think it's reactive. We need to be more proactive with our policies, basically.
All right. Thank you so much. Because of time, that's all we can have.
Thank you.